Okay, today in this lecture we are going to derive the elasticity of substitution for a Cobb-Douglas production function. Suppose that Cobb-Douglas production function is given by k is equal to L to the power alpha and k trace to the power beta. First of all, we need to calculate the technical rate of substitution, and after that we will calculate the elasticity of substitution for the Cobb-Douglas production function. Technical rate of substitution, for technical rate of substitution, it is mandatory to take the first derivative of the function. So take the derivative of this function with respect to labor. We need key on L, which is equal to alpha time L raised to the power alpha minus 1 and k to the power beta. So this is the derivative of the function with respect to labor. Similarly, derivative of the function with respect to capital, this is equal to L to the power alpha and beta time k raised to the power beta minus 1. So this is the marginal physical product of labor, and this shows the marginal physical product of capital. The marginal rate of technical substitution, your technical rate of substitution, is obtained by q L divided by q k, or this is equal to alpha L to the power alpha less 1 k to the power beta, and it should be divided by L to the power alpha. You can write beta in the start of the function, beta time L raised to the power alpha and k raised to the power beta minus 1. So what we can do is, this is equal to alpha and k to the power beta, we can shift this beta minus 1 to the numerator. So this will be minus beta plus 1. In the same way, we can shift the beta time L to the power alpha. If we shift this alpha minus 1 to the denominator, it will be minus alpha plus 1. So plus beta minus beta plus alpha minus alpha. We are left with alpha k divided by beta l. So this is equal to technical rate of substitution. Technical rate of substitution is equal to alpha by beta time k by l. If we solve it for k by l, this implies that k by l, this is equal to beta over alpha time beta over alpha time technical rate of substitution. Technical rate of substitution. Now, as we know from the previous video, that elasticity of substitution can be written as elasticity of substitution, this is equal to d differential of the log of k by l. If we divided it by differential of the log of technical rate of substitution in absolute form, so you get the elasticity of substitution. So that's why, let's suppose this is equation number A, and if we take the log of this function, we will get log of k by l. This is equal to, according to the log rule, this is equal to log of beta over alpha, which is constant, and it becomes plus log of technical rate of substitution. We applied this rule, log of m into n, this is equal to log of m plus log of n. We applied this rule. Okay, now taking the derivative of this with respect to this technical rate of substitution in absolute form. Technical rate of substitution, we take it absolute because technical rate of substitution appears with negative sign. But since we know that we cannot take the log of negative value, that's why we are taking it in absolute form. So what we are doing is, taking the derivative, the derivative of the function with respect to technical rate of substitution. So d by d log of technical rate of substitution of log of k by l left hand side d by d log of technical rate of substitution of the log of beta over alpha or plus d by d log of technical rate of substitution of log of technical rate of substitution an absolute form. Don't mess the absolute sign. Okay, so what we get is that this is constant, right? Alpha log of beta over alpha is constant. So this derivative is equal to zero, right? And the derivative of log of technical rate of substitution with respect to technical rate of substitution, its power is 1. So that's why overall this derivative is equal to 1. So this is equal to 1. This is equal to elasticity of substitution of Cobb-Douglas production function with respect to Cobb-Douglas production function. Thank you. Thanks for watching.